Hello people, hello. So here we have a Dodge again, and I've decided we are going to go 9 volts just because he is turbo, and who really cares if he flies off the tracks. So what I'm going to do is make it so we can fit a 9 volt battery, but also leave the fitment there if you need to put a 1.5 volt C cell in. So you've got the option to do both. So what we're going to do is connect the wires away from this actual area here. We're going to connect it underneath. So we're going to pop off his front wheel carrier like so and remove the wheels. And so now you can see this part of the battery connection runs underneath and along there. So what we're going to do is, with my trusty gas powered soldering iron and some solder, which if you remember is like electrical glue, we are just going to put a little bit of solder on that wire. It's called tinning. Then what we're going to do is pop the wire through the hole, and we're going to solder it onto the back there. This might be a little bit fiddly. I think what I'll do is actually, that's a bit odd there. We'll pop that through the actual hole like that, and we will blob a little bit of solder just on there, if we can get it hot enough. Right, that now has filled Dodge's little area at the bottom there. So we'll just make sure that's all level, which it is. And probably a little bit hot. Okay, let's pop his wheel back in. And pop on the wheel carrier like that, and that gives us our first connection. Now, like I said, the second connection really needs to be away from here so we can still connect a 9 volt battery. So I think what we need to do is take that wire and actually go through the side hole and connect it up. So let's just get that wire out of there, should we? Make sure there's no random little bits hanging around. And we shall get this wire and give him a twist. And we shall pop some solder onto that wire again, just to give it a bit of a helping hand if it will stay still. Just let this heat up. So we'll pop some on that wire, and we shall feed this wire through the side. Let's see if it'll come through. Will it come through, or will it hit on something else? Oh, is that a little slot at the bottom? No, it's not. Okay. just have to just lift that area up slightly, like so. Now this wire should feed through just about almost here. Yeah, it's been a little bit fiddling. Yeah, there we go, we're through. So we're going to call that the second connection. What I'm going to do is just solder that onto those connections there, just so we've got a good connection. So we shall get the soldering iron out and try and get that wire to stay where we want it to first before we put some solder on it. Yeah, that's good, it's good, it's good, it's good. Okay, we've got that there, so let's put some solder onto the connection down below. Okay, push that back in there. So now it should. One moment, please. Just trying to find a battery. Not having much luck. Let me check over here. Yes, there we go. So. Don't forget, this originally comes with a C size, which I still haven't got. But this is the same length, don't forget the AA. So we'll pop that on. And that's flat. Yeah, that's flat. Okay, let me try another one. And let's put this one in. And there you go. So. If we want non-turbo Thomas, slow snail pace Thomas, we can use the AA or AC, or if we want turbo crazy speed Thomas, we simply connect this and might tidy up the wires, otherwise you've literally just got to just tuck them out of the way like that, and woo! Super speed. I keep calling Thomas, don't I? It's not Thomas, is it? It's Dodge. But yeah, I might get some hot glue out if I can find a suitable adult to help me with the hot glue, and we shall do that. So that's his actual engine modifications done. I think I'll leave the 9-volt one in for now. And while you were away, I have sprayed Dodge's body with the lacquer because it's a bit of an intricate job, and there's not too much to be seen. Okay, kind of gave him a spray while I wasn't filming, just because the fact it can be a little bit fiddly. So, as you can see, he's got a good little bit of shine on there. If I can actually get him in the camera. Hang on a sec. Yes, there, look. He's on the stick again. But as you can see, he's now got a nice shine on him. I can't really get a good angle in here. I need to tidy my workbench really, don't I? But yes, look at the shine on that. So you can polish him if you get your mum or dad's best soft sock, you can polish him up. So once he's completely dry tomorrow, we shall clip him on the body and basically just do a very small video of the unveiling of Turbo Dodge. Oh yeah! Thanks for watching, subscribe, hit the like button, blah 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 blah, goodbye.